everyone, and welcome to our tutorial on the text-to-speech feature.
Peppermint, cedarwood, bergamot, myrrh.
The text-to-speech feature converts any written text inside your virtual tour into spoken words, so it reads digital text aloud.
Bergamot.
This is not only useful in terms of web accessibility, where alt text options are essential for people with disabilities such as blindness or dyslexia, it's useful for all virtual tour visitors.
Perfume organ. The perfumer's
content can be read aloud to people who prefer to listen, for example, while navigating the tour, rather than having to stop and read a whole lot of text. And particularly in VR headsets, those are simply not meant to be reading texts on. So having that text read out to you aloud gives a richer experience not only to the visually impaired. The text-to-speech feature can be applied to all sorts of text you can find in a virtual tour. It can read out info window texts, tooltips, buttons,
subscribe,
or even play an audio description of the current media, be it a panorama or a 360-degree video for those who have difficulties seeing images.
A perfumer works like a musician creating a composition of different notes.
As the perfumer creates their masterpiece on paper, they would bring it to life olfactively by taking the raw materials and weighing them each individually into a glass beaker.
Granted, it does sound a little bit robotic, but the idea here is not to replace
Peppermint.
Actual professional voiceover and audio,
Bergamot.
But to extend the reach of
Myrrh.
Your virtual tours with one simple click to a much broader user base, to make that content accessible by citizens with visual, auditory, and other physical limitations and disabilities. So let's get right into it. The tool itself is very easy. It is located inside 3D Vista VT Pro in the Publish tab. Down here on the bottom right, you can find the section with different settings that purely define the voice that'll be reading out the text. So we have volume, the rate, which is basically the speed with which the voice will be speaking, and the pitch, with which you select whether you prefer to have a higher pitched voice or a lower pitched voice read out the texts. And finally, upon selecting these checkboxes, you determine which types of texts inside your tour should be automatically read out to the visitor. For instance, if we mark the info window checkbox, when we create a pop-up info window in our tour with a column of text, then that text will be automatically read out to the user as soon as they open the info window. The same goes for quiz cards in an e-learning tour, whether it's the questions or the answers. And finally, also for tooltips, which are the little tags that appear next to your mouse on rolling over certain elements inside the tour. So by ticking that, apart from appearing as a little text tag, it'll also be read out aloud when hovering over the element. In fact, let's start with this one. So we tick it and we go to one of our panoramas to create a tooltip that can then be read out to us, just so you see how it goes. So in the hotspot tab, I already created some hotspots here. And if we select one of them, here to the right, we can see that I also already typed peppermint as a tooltip for this one. So let's preview and see what happens.
Peppermint, cedarwood, vetiver, cedarwood.
And that's our tooltips read aloud when they appear with the voice settings that we had configured. So the pitch, the rate, and the volume. If you didn't like that voice, you can go back and tweak those parameters a little bit. So that was easy. Now let's see how we can get any of the other text types to be read out to us. For instance, let's go to the skin and have a look at an info window that I already prepared for this. This info window is actually a skin element made out of a number of containers. Don't confuse this with the standard pop-up info window that you can select in your individual hotspot actions inside the panoramas. So this is just created inside the skin. I inserted some text manually, a button down here, etc. And this button, when clicked, should be doing the following. It should start reading out this text right here. I have this action created here already, but let's delete that so you can see how it's done from scratch. So we have our button selected in the viewer and we click Add Action. Now, amongst all of these different possible actions, we have text to speech right here. We click that. We'll leave it at click, so this defines when the action should be triggered. Yes, we want it when the button is actually clicked, but you can also define it for a simple rollover or upon start, etc. like any other button action. And then there we have a number of actions. They can basically be grouped into two categories. These first two, which would be for the actual reading aloud of content, whether it's text, which we will check out in a minute, or skin elements, which is the one we're going to use now. And then we have these remaining four here, which control this voiceover, this reading aloud. So if we want to stop any current reading, if we want to disable all text-to-speech of this tour, or enable it, or make a toggle between those two states. So these four are for the general control of the text-to-speech feature. And these two will define which text we want to read aloud with our button. Like I said, we'll be using this one. Now we have this new option opening up, which we should now define, and that is where we select which skin component within our open container we want read out to us. So this lists my different skin elements inside the open container, which I had named text, by button text, and so on. So whatever you would name your skin components here, that would appear in this list right here for you to choose from. So do you want the text read out, which would be all this text right here? Or do we want to read out specific buttons even? And here we have two different buttons. For this one, I used a text button element from the skin component library, but instead of making it actual text inside the button, I just used this headphone icon. But if it had text, then that would be read aloud when I select this button in the list. And then I also have a second hidden button here, which is this one in the list, by button text, which we could also have read out to us. But what we want to do is have the text body here read out to us. And that's that. So when that window appears and the user clicks the button, they'll be hearing a voice read this text to them. Let's hide this window by default and go to the panorama to select that the window should appear when clicking on this hotspot. I actually already did that, so here we have our action to show hide that info window when we click on that info hotspot. Let's see. Click on the hotspot. And we see that info window, and when I click on the button...
Perfume Organ. The perfumer's working tool. As the perfumer creates their masterpiece on paper, they would bring it to life olfactively by taking the raw materials and weighing them each individually into a glass beaker that would be sitting on a balance at the center of the organ.
So it reads the whole text out to us. Each perfumer favors different raw materials. And in fact, it does not stop reading when I close the window, which may not actually be what you want. Maybe we should have set that to stop as well. So let's go back in and see how we can make it stop reading as soon as the user closes the window. Therefore, we go back to that skin element, we select the closing button, and apart from closing that window, it should also have the action to stop the text-to-speech voiceover. So, let's add a second action, text-to-speech, and it's actually good that this happened so you can see how one of the other text-to-speech actions are actually used. So, here we now select Stop Any Speech.
Perfume Organ.
It starts reading.
The perfumer's working tool.
And it stops upon closing the info window so we can continue looking around without audio. And finally, you can also play a narration of something that is not even actually included as text inside your tour. So something that you define just for this purpose. And I'll demonstrate that by assigning it to media, for instance a panorama, as a whole, rather than to one of the hotspots inside it. So we select the panorama in Settings, Add Action, Text to Speech, and the option we have not demonstrated yet is Text. which opens up this little box right here, where we can type in any text that at start, so when the panorama opens, will be read aloud. So this text will not actually appear in the tour as written text. It's just for the speech. So this text will be read aloud as soon as we enter this panorama, which makes it useful as support for the visually impaired to describe what is being seen in this panorama, or for instance, to play some sort of welcome message at the beginning of a tour, etc.
Welcome to the perfume organ. To design a perfume, a perfumer works like a musician creating a composition of different notes.
And of course, we still have our other text-to-speech elements in here as well, which we had defined earlier.
Peppermint. Cedarwood.
And that's it. That's how you use the text-to-speech function in 3D Vista V2 Pro. As a final add-on, let's have a quick look at a sample tour to see how this text-to-speech feature is integrated with the multi-language tool for 3D Vista Tours. So if you have your tour available in two languages, the text-to-speech voice will always automatically read in the language that you have currently selected. There is a separate video tutorial on multi-language, so we won't go into detail on that. Just know that here we have two buttons in our tour where the user can switch between languages to view the tour in. And here in Publish and under Language, we have our two languages defined, English and Spanish. So if we open this, we have the translations of all of our elements, texts, the hotspots, the tooltips, etc. Let's preview.
Perfume organ. The perfumer's working tool.
That was English. And if we switch to the tour in Spanish now.
Menta. Madera de cedro.
See how it also changes the text to speech to that language?
Peppermint. Cedarwood.
And of course, also for the info window, it reads that text in the current language. In fact, it even implies the specific accent of a certain language. So we selected the Spanish
Organo
for Spain rather than, for instance, the Mexican pronunciation.
A medida que
and that's it. As you can see, a very fast and easy thing to add to your tours, but that could potentially have a big impact on your target audience. And eventually may even decide whether or not you will even get a certain project if your client exceeds certain accessibility standards, which are common not only in public tenders, but also more and more in private projects. Thanks for watching.